Good morning and happy Sabbath. So I will be reading from Psalms 52, verses 8 and 9, that can be found on page 527 of your church Bibles. But I am like an olive tree, flourishing in the house of God. I trust in God's unfailing love forever and ever. For what you have done, I will always praise you in the presence of your faithful people. And I will hope in your name, for your name is good. Thank you.
If you could all stand and join us in singing All Creatures of Our God and King, which is located on page 2 in your hymnals.
All creatures of our God and King, lift up your voice with us and sing. Alleluia, alleluia. O morning sun with golden beam, and silver moon with softer gleam. Oh, praise him, oh, praise him. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Oh, rushing wind and breezes soft, that ride the winds aloft. Oh, praise him, alleluia. Oh, rising morning, praise rejoice. Oh, lights of evening, find a voice. Pure and clear, make music for your Lord to hear. Oh, praise him, alleluia. Oh, why so masterful and kind, providing us with warmth and light. Oh, praise him, oh, praise him, alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Creator bless and worship him in humbleness. Oh, praise him, alleluia. Oh, praise the Father, praise the Son, and praise the Spirit, three in one. Oh, praise him, oh, praise him, alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
And singing verse 1 one more time.
All creatures of our God and King, lift up your voice with us and sing. Alleluia, alleluia. Oh, burning sun with golden beam, and silver moon with softer gleam. Oh, praise him, oh,
if you could all kneel and join us in singing our prayer song, hymn number 671.
As we pray, take our hearts and our minds far away from the press of the world all around, to your throne where grace does abound. May our lives be transformed by your love. May our souls be refreshed from above. At this moment, let people everywhere
Our dear Lord and Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for the joy of the many gifts you've given to us, for the children today, their parents, and for the joy of you having here joining us. We would lift you up and give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen.
All right. If you are enjoying, the fine temperature we have inside the building, raise your hand. If you're enjoying the ability to have illumination to see all the bright shining faces, raise your hand. All right. That comes from something called church budget. It never goes away. It's like Jesus's love. It is always there for us. It's not always the most exciting thing that we can give to, but it is the thing that powers all so many ministries in this church. So that is what our offering is for today. So if you appreciate any of these things, you don't have to write church budget on your giving envelope because it's going to go there anyway. But if you have if you need to, or are returning your tithes, you want to write that out, designate that. Or if you're going to give to, let's say, Family Promise, you heard what our need is there. If the Spirit's moving you to do that, we do need you to fill out on a giving envelope what it is you'd like to give to if it's not church budget. And we have lots of opportunities. We have the Prison Bible Fund. We have Children's Ministries. We have Family Promise. So lots of things that you can get behind with your resources. Today, our main offering is going for church budget because we all need it all the time. I'll have our collectors stand up and let's have a quick little prayer for the offering before we take it up. Dear Father in Heaven, thank you so much for the blessings that we've seen and the God sightings that we've seen this week during VBS. Bless this service so that your light can shine through, and bless this church and all of its ministries so that people can see God sightings through us. In Jesus' name, amen.
I invite all of the kids who are at VBS to do the hand motions with us as we sing My Hope is in the Lord. Come on. and just join us for our children's sermon. Just go ahead and sit all right here. Come back, come back. And we'll have Miss Gray come up and tell us about our children's story.
All right, my children, come on back. You're going to face our church family over here. How about that singing church family? Right? Oh. There's something special about when children sing. I think God's ears really perk up. And the angel.
We have lots in there.
All right. Wow, full house. I like this. Have a seat right there, love. Come on in, girls. Wow, I'm seeing some familiar faces from this week. We had a good week, didn't we? Yeah. It was a good week, amen. And we learned so many lessons. Let's have our eyes on me and our voices are off. I'm going to tell you a story today about a little girl named Emily. How many of you, raise your hands, know how to ride a bike? Yeah? Wow, impressive. We need to do a bike-a-thon, church. How many of you remember when you used to use training wheels? Yeah, you know what training wheels are? You know, that extra support that you have on your, I'm gonna get on my bike here. Doesn't it fit me just perfectly? Thank you, Reagan, for lending me your frozen bike here. I remember when I learned how to ride a bike. It was pretty scary. I knew mom and dad were there, right? And they had me and they were holding my handlebars and my training wheels were fine. They wouldn't let me, you know, go either way. But I think the scary part came when mom and dad took the training wheels off. Oh, I don't know if many of you remember that, but when those training wheels came off, oh, that was a scary part. Well, this little girl, Emily, I'm going to tell you a story about. She had just learned to ride a bike without training wheels. And she thought it was wonderful. They'd go on family bike rides and they'd go around the block. And she was like, this is the best thing ever. And every day after dinner, she'd say, Mom and Dad, can we go for a bike ride? Please, 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 please. Right? Because she was so excited. She knew how to ride her bike. And her parents said, sure, no problem. And so one day they said, let's go on a bike ride. Grab your helmet, grab your knee pads, let's go. And so she got on her bike and there they go, riding along, riding along, riding along. And then she didn't realize, but after they were riding and riding and riding around the neighborhood, she ended up on the top of a very, very, hopefully I can ride backwards, a very large hill. And when she looked down, she saw a really steep hill. And she said, uh-oh, I can't do this, Mommy. No, 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 no. And Mommy said, yes, you can. No, Mommy, do you see how big that hill is? I'll fall. I'll go so fast, I'm gonna fall. And Mommy said, no, you can do this. You know how. We wouldn't make you do anything we haven't, you know, we don't think you're ready for. And she said, Mommy, I don't want to do it. And she started to cry and the tears came down. She said, Mommy, please don't make me do it. I'm scared. I'm scared. And she said, why are you scared? We've trained you for this. You're ready for this. Have courage. And so her mommy said, how about you just ride to that little tree right there and I'll hold the back of your bike. And she said, well, okay. I trust Mommy. So she went. Just a little bit. Just to the tree. She wasn't going to go any further than that. Okay, Mommy, I'm at the tree. I did it. Whew. I didn't fall. I'm good. Okay. Mommy said, see, you did it. How about you go just a little further? But this time, I'm not going to hold the bike for you. I'm going to run alongside you. And she said, okay, I trust mommy. She's never let me down. She keeps her word to me. Okay, she's not gonna let me get hurt, so here I go. And so she went, and she pedaled, and she got there, and then she stopped at that tree, and she said, oh, I did it, mommy, I did it. And mommy said, of course you did it. I knew you could. You're ready for this. Now, how about you go that last little part down the hill all by yourself? And she said, well, oh, mommy, I'm still scared, but I'm gonna do it, because I trust you. I really trust you, mommy. I'm gonna have courage, and I'm gonna do this, because I trust you. You have told me I can do this. I know I can do this. I've learned to do this. I'm gonna do it. And so she got on her bike, and she went down that hill, the last little part, and not only did she do it, but she enjoyed it, and she even got a little crazy and was like, woo, hands in the air, woo, and she got there, and then she stopped, she put her brakes on, and she's like, I did it, mommy and daddy, I did it. And her parents ran down after her, and they said, we know, we knew you could do it. You needed to have courage. You needed to trust us. Who says that to us? Who do we know says that to us? Abby. Thank you, Abby. Who? God, right? Yes, God says it to us, doesn't he? And we find one of my favorite verses is in Joshua 1:9. He says, this is my command. Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or discouraged, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Everywhere, right? He's with you. He's by your side. Even if there's something scary, we know that we're ready for it, and God gives us that courage, and he's there to support us every step of the way. Amen. Right? Yes. So if you feel scared sometime, remember this. And if you have a friend who's maybe scared, maybe you can encourage them as well. All right. Here's what I'm going to ask of my little people. We're going to go collect our offering. We're going to look at them, and we're going to say thank you. Right? Awesome. All right. Go ahead, my little ones. Happy Sabbath.
At this time, we are going to kick off our VBS Spotlight with singing our theme song. And so many of our Cave Quest members know this song so well, so I would like to invite them up once they come back from collecting the lamb's offering. And this song has a special call and response. And so we're going to be ooing, and we'll make a call or a call, and then we're going to point at you, and the congregation will have to respond. This whole week has been so much fun, and you know, we've learned so many cool songs, and we've met so many new friends. And you know, we met this friend Claire, and you know, we've been seeing her every day, and we've been able to teach her a few things about Jesus.
Friends.
Claire, guys, this is our friend.
What do you? Hi.
How are you? I mean, last time we saw you, you were getting ready for a huge cave expedition. You know, she's trying to become a certified cave leader. And in order to do that, she needs to lead a cave leader. She needs to lead a group of people, and she needs to lead them really well.
Will you say that's true? Your abilities to remember things are uncanny. I'm actually about to begin a leading expedition right now.
Well, shouldn't you be preparing? Why are you here?
That's actually why I'm here. Do you remember what happens when I get nervous?
Yeah, you faint.
Correct. I've been actually feeling really, really
nervous. No. No more fainting.
I just keep thinking, what if I fail? Like, I'll never be a good caver.
Come on, what's the first thing that we talked about when we met each other?
Well, you said my personal fall stopper was a toilet plunger.
It is a toilet plunger. But that's not all we talked about. We also talked about how Jesus can give us hope.
Follow him!
You're right. Thanks for reminding me. That's actually what I needed to hear. I better go round up my team.
Of course. I can't wait to meet them. You know, I bet she's going to have a great team. She's going to be such a good leader. She was so close to getting her certification, but she just needs to do this one last thing, and then she's going to be great. Look, there's her team now.
Right here.
Who are all these people? And there's more, too?
This is my caving team I'm leading. Cavers, would you like to introduce yourself?
Hey, I'm Trevor. I'm going to be leading this expedition.
No, Trevor, you're not.
Wait.
I'm the leader. We went over this.
No, maybe later.
No. Well, anyway, we have our resident cool kid, Allie.
Yo, yo, yo. Wait, hey. Yo, yo, what's up, my cave people? We should toast, be like a sack of the tight, and hang sometime.
Yeah, I have no idea what you're saying. And then there's Grant. He's a bit of an adrenaline junkie.
You got that right, boss. You name it. I've jumped off of a lot of stuff. Boats, cars, planes, trains, motorcycles, helicopters, submarines, horses, cliffs, hot air balloons, trees, large fish.
Wait, how did you jump off a large fish?
It's a long story. I'll tell you later.
I'm going to want to hear the rest of that. Finally, we have Emily, who actually I do not know much about.
Hi, I'm...
Emily, do you get a little nervous in front of people? That's okay. You know, Claire does too. But guess what? This week, we learned that Jesus can give us courage.
Follow him!
Does that make you feel any better?
I'm feeling pretty brave. Courage is amazing.
That's so good.
I know, right? That courage helped me be less scared in the caves.
What, you were scared of the dark? A true leader like me isn't afraid of anything. I don't need any help navigating these caves.
Well, you know what, Trevor? You're right. Why don't you go take the map and go around in all these caves?
I'm gonna go this way.
Let's see if he can do it.
Whoa! Hey, don't go that way. There's kind of a lot of bats and stuff.
Yeah, it's called the Bat Cavern.
Okay, well, alright! Let's go this way.
Alright, go.
Whoa! Hey, guys! It's really slippery over here.
Yeah, it's called Cave Snot. And don't stand up because it's probably on your shoes.
Oh, man. Oh, good thing I had this handy dandy, ball stopper to help me, or else I would have fallen real far down that cave.
Well, when you're as clumsy as I am, you have to learn a few tricks to get your way through the caves. I also learned that Jesus gives us direction.
Follow him!
When you let Jesus guide you, he will lead you exactly where you need to go.
You know, that's a great point, Claire. You know, we learned so many good things this whole week.
I used to feel like I had to do things on my own, but now I just know that God has strength and I have some too.
It's her.
Yeah, it is. But do you want to know what else is cool?
Sure.
Yeah, let's see it.
My helmet, or as I like to call it, my brain shield. What I do is turn it slightly to the right, and I think it gives me that street geologist look.
I still have no idea what you're talking about.
Respect, little man, respect.
What?
That's okay. I got you, Allie. Makes total sense. Hey, you know what would make you even cooler?
Don't hold me out on me now. You gotta keep me in the loop. Tell me.
Okay, so in order to know how a cave expert, or, you know, a cave follower like you, is really cool is how they walk.
The way they walk?
That's right. You know what? Try walking like a penguin. That's how you can tell. Go for it.
Okay, I got it.
That's right. Yeah. That's totally cool, right, guys? And guess what? You know what would be even cooler?
What?
You know, make some farm animal noises while you're doing it.
Okay.
Moo!
Just like that. Yeah? Try adding a few chickens. Yeah.
Hey! You guys are messing with me. That's not cool.
I'm sorry, Allie. It just seems a little silly that you're so obsessed with being cool.
I'm just afraid that if I'm not cool, then people won't like me.
Allie, do you want to hear something that we learned this week?
Sure. Really? Yeah, sure.
This week, we learned that Jesus can give us his love.
Follow him!
Really? How much does he love me?
He loves you so much that he died for you, and that he takes on the consequences of the bad things that we do.
Wow, if Jesus loves me so much, I guess I don't have to worry about what other people think of me.
Exactly, that's right.
Wait, where did Grant go?
Look out below!
Grant, you have to stop doing that. It's not safe. You should be jumping around in a cage.
Oh, I can't help it, dude. I see a ledge and I have to jump off of it.
What are you talking about? Of course you can help it.
Nope, I wish I wasn't. But I really can't help it. In fact, I see a ledge right now.
No, that is a particularly dangerous ledge that you cannot jump off of.
Sorry, boss, I just can't resist.
Yes, you can. You can resist. Something else that we learned this week is that Jesus gives us his power.
Follow him!
Really? Because right now it seems pretty impossible that I won't try and jump off this ledge.
You know, with Jesus' power, we can do things that seem impossible on our own. Try it.
Okay, I can do this.
You got it.
Wow, so Jesus, hold on. Wow, so Jesus, your power can really overcome challenges.
That's right.
It's the most powerful thing ever. In fact, without Jesus' power, I probably would have given this whole expedition up a week ago.
But I'm so glad that you are here and that you are able to learn all of these things with me and all of my friends.
Well, we're glad you didn't.
Well, Cavers, I'm fairly certain that we have learned something today. Excellent. Now let's continue our quest. But first, we have a personal fall stopper salute. Thanks for everything, everybody. I'm sure I'll get my certification.
Wait, the map says go this way.
Oh. Bye. See you later. Oh. Claire, are you okay? Claire. Oh, still the same old Claire. But I'm so happy that we were able to learn all of these things together. It was a great week at VBS, right, guys?
Wasn't that an awesome drama? I can't wait to see some more of that skit in the future. But now, for those of you that missed this amazing week, we have a spotlight presentation for you to enjoy with the kids.
Look at us. follow his lead and
up our scripture readers, Alina, Santiago, Ryan, and Amber, to come on up. Our scriptures today are taken from our daily Bible points, so I will start with Alina.
Take courage, I am here, Matthew 14:27. He will show you which path to take, Proverbs 3:6.
In all your ways, submit to him, Proverbs 3:6.
This is how we know that Jesus love is. Jesus Christ laid down his life for us. John 3:16.
Our great power is from God, not from ourselves. 2 Corinthians 4:7.
Thanks, kids.
Let me just use this one. It's close by. For the world's shortest sermon, here we go. I like to always start with a word of prayer, so if you just bow your heads. Dear Lord and Heavenly Father, we thank you for the joy of this Sabbath day with you, and we would ask your Holy Spirit to guide and direct and bless us in this Sabbath experience. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I'd like to say to the parents out here today, we so appreciate your young ones. I had a wonderful time this last week. I know this, all the staff did. Everyone that was involved just had so much fun with each one of the children, and they were a real blessing to us too. So thank you, parents, so much for bringing them. What a joy we had. I'd like to just share with you very short thoughts this afternoon that somewhat parallel our week with the children. And every once in a while, you might hear them speak up just a little bit. When I think about their enthusiasm and their excitement, sometimes the things we shared, I wondered if they were applicable at all. I'm sure they were. But one of the themes that we talked about and started this last week was with the concept of hope. And I know that many of your young people don't have a challenge with hope. I heard, I hope I get a new bicycle. I hope I get a new video game. I hope. But I'd like to share with adults today that we live in a challenging time to be an adult. It may not be quite as challenging when you're young, but as adults, we are very challenged in the time we live in. And hope is one of the biggest challenges. I know most of you are probably really reeling from what happened 2 days ago in Nice, France. And as I listen to the commentators and the things that try to explain why these things might have happened, I've come to the conclusion that our world has individuals, many individuals all over the place that really don't have any hope. There's no hope left for them. And this is the one crying salvo on the way out, is to get the attention of individuals saying, look, I have no hope. But parents and church members, church family, let me tell you, we are not a people that are without hope, are we? When I think of what it would be like to enter into this life, face it day after day and all the challenges that come in life without the hope of the great good news that Jesus Christ has left for us, the reality that he has that God has given His Son because He finds us so precious and loves us so much He wants to have us back home again and to not see us have to face the challenges we face. This is the greatest hope of all, is to be able to count on the promises that God has given us through His Son, Jesus Christ. I just want to counsel you, parents, to do something that your kids might say in a moment, because Jesus is the hope. Yes. If you let Jesus into your life, make Him the center of your life, He will give you a hope that will amount to something that everyone around you will not quite understand and grasp, but want it very badly. How we can, as parents, maintain through the challenges we have day to day and make it is something the world may not understand, but we do it because we have the hope of Jesus' soon return. The second thing we have is a gift from God, too. It's the courage to face those challenges. I can remember back when I was 4 or 5 years old. That's probably why I enjoyed being a youth pastor so much. It was just like being young again and experiencing all those things all over again. But I can remember when I was young, it seems like I had courage for everything. But through the years, I sometimes want to say to myself, I'm not sure I want to step out of that car today, or I'm not sure if I want to go on the freeway, or I'm not sure if I want to. There's so many challenges in lives. And yet the reality is that Jesus gives us courage, doesn't He? Courage to deal with the things at work. Courage to be able to deal with the challenges at home. Courage to be able to face the mail and see what comes again today. But because we have Jesus in our life, we can face that thing with His presence. He also gives us direction. I know that Jesus gives us direction. You know, I don't know about you, but not all the decisions now in life are that easy to make. Some of them are really, really challenging. I'm so glad I have someone to ask for advice, for guidance, to do things that I don't seem to be humanly possible to do. This is something that God can supply for us. The wonderful gift of His direction. You know He will never let you down. The next thing He brings is amazing to me, and that is love. He not only gives us love, but He says to give out that love too. There are some people I've run into life, although they're rare, that I find it very uncomfortable to be around. It stretches my ability to be able to love. Even within my family, there are times when my little ones, when they were little, became a challenge for that loving experience. Sometimes they gave it back and said, you may have heard that. It was just temporary, and it wasn't true. But the reality is love can be very challenging. But God loved us so much that He gave His Son once again, that whoever would believe in Him wouldn't have to face this life forever, could go home again with Him and experience it forever and ever and ever. And He gave that love to us, not thinking that we would hold on to it, but that we would give it out to those around us, even the ones that are hard to give. The last thing is the one I give God glory for. But I want to ask kids, I just about forgot about this. I wanted to tell you that Jesus gives us love.
Okay.
He does. The last one I wanted to share with you today, parents, is that Jesus gives us power. Sometimes we don't think we have any power at all. And sometimes we feel pretty powerless. But the reality is that He's given us all those things I talked about, and He will empower us to be able to give them to somebody else. If you feel that there is something you just don't know how or why you'd want to do it, but you know it has to be done, He gave us the Holy Spirit to be able to go to and empower us to be able to do something we can't even do ourselves. Did you know that if we ask God, He will even change our desires for us? But God, there's something I don't even want to do, but I know I ought to do it. Could you help me? And the promise is, I can, because Jesus has given me power. My blessing is going to go with each one of your parents, that you, when you go home, you continue to live in the hope and have the courage and get the direction and have the love and the power to be a part of your kids' life and watch them mature in Jesus Christ and grow up to be kids that make you really proud. Let's pray. Dear Lord and Heavenly Father, thank You for Your love. Thank You for Your promises. We look forward to Your presence. In Jesus' name, amen.
If you could all stand and join us in singing Everlasting God, and the lyrics will be up on the screen.
We will wait upon the Lord, our God.
And now, dear Lord, as we close, we continue to ask your presence with each child here and each parent. May our joy in you overflow today. Amen.
Vacation Bible School kids to come on up. I would love to have one group picture of all the kids before our beautiful set goes away. So anybody wearing a Cave Quest shirt or anybody else that wants to join in on our group picture, come on up.